It's been almost 2 months since our previous episode of SpaceX in the news, so let's briefly catch up on things. Since my last video debriefing Test Flight 4 on June 13th, SpaceX released a highlight reel of the mission on X, which included a panoramic landing burn of the booster taken from a buoy or something. Leaked images of the aftermath showed a massive fireball on the surface of the sea. Apparently, that's not supposed to happen after the tip-over, according to FAA documents. However, it did, according to LAPS infrasound data. Speaking of the FAA, the federal agency sent out emails a week or so ago announcing SpaceX's proposal to increase the number of Starship launches and landings at Boca Chica to as many as 25 annually. They are once again seeking public comments, which is always such a hoot to listen to. The projected liftoff timeframe for Starship's next test flight, TF-5, has come and gone. In fact, it's been so long since I've last looked into these things, I had to use Grok to remind myself which stages it's supposed to use. Static fires have occurred in preparation for the next test mission, but the launch tower remains empty at this time. And next to it, you can see the progress being made on the second tower. Major progress has also been made on Starship's new Raptor engine. The first Raptor 3 variant made its public debut, looking much cleaner than the two previous versions. Improvements have been made across the board to thrust, specific impulse, mass, you name it. But what's also huge is that Raptor 3 doesn't require any heat shield at all. Elon says the engine pushes the boundary of known physics. The next big event SpaceX has on the agenda is the launch of Polaris Dawn, the mission that will host the first commercial astronauts to perform an EVA after bringing their Dragon capsule down to vacuum. The new EVA suits are now complete and fully tested, and the targeted launch date is currently the 26th of August. In other SpaceX news, NASA announced last month that SpaceX has been given the honor of destroying the International Space Station. The company has been tasked with developing a new and more powerful unmanned Dragon spacecraft to dock with and deorbit the ISS in 2030. That very same day, Elon also made the announcement that SpaceX will be moving its headquarters out of California and into Texas due to the progressive anti-family and anti-business policies of leftist Governor Gavin Newsom. For those same reasons, Elon is moving X's HQ as well. So keep up the good work destroying your own states, Democrats. But before I sign off, I do want to thank those of you who are still supporting the channel. Again, it's because of you I'm still working this channel at all. So God bless and Godspeed.